the exhibition that's being shown here is Exotic Lies, Sacred Ties. It's a survey show of work from the last 10 or 12 years, which looks at different elements of my practice that have a real kind of focus on Australian history, shared histories, Indigenous perspectives, and also conceptual and theoretical frameworks, which are part of that whole dialogue and narrative about the histories from settlement until now. My family comes from North Queensland. My father's family, a few generations ago, came from America and England and arrived in Mackay in North Queensland and farmed up there on cane farms. And my mother's family were from further north, they're from Cairns, and my mother's Indigenous family from the Atherton. In the exhibition, there's a real focus in many of the works on blue and white, and that particular palette has quite a significant kind of reading in those images. Blue and white is drawn in these cases primarily from a spate of matchwood, and it's part of that tradition of transfer ware that was generated in the late 18th century at about the same time Australia was being colonised and settled. So blue and white imagery has this really interesting kind of cross-cultural dialogue happening within it already, and so blue and white in my work represents the transformed or the changed landscape. Within that imagery which is here, I incorporate figurative elements, and they are naturalistic depictions of Indigenous people at about that time of contact and about that time of settlement. There's also elements of Australian wildlife which are pictured as well. So the composition really draw heavily on historical traditions and narratives. And as I say, talk about the contextual relationship between environment and people at about that time in our history. So they become a really important kind of indication, if you like, of the experience of people and also the way they would have experienced that change. So it's an unfolding kind of comment on shared history, on multiple histories, and on a cultural dialogue which takes place against the backdrop of enlightenment kinds of, you could call it, perceptions about the exotic. And also too, in relation to the development of photography at about the time Aboriginal people began to be pictured, it was very much about the idea of the scientific eye and capturing, if you like, the ethnographic or anthropological subject, and which is a kind of a complex conversation as well, because it has implications in terms of the identity of Aboriginal people and also how culture was read at about that time. So in many of the images there is a very strong focus on compositional elements such as the frame or the floral border that appears in the pictures. Now, floral borders or borders themselves become very important framing devices because they suggest to the viewer that in fact the image or the scene unfolding within that frame and border is an allegorical or a poetic space. And it talks about the experience of the narrative in the picture, not so much a factual representation or a recounting of an actual event. Counting and a retelling of an experience. So when we read that, we read it as an analogous series of signs and symbols which point to, you could say, both specific and very broad and general histories.